Well, hello there, me darlings. Today I'd like to start to sing to you instead of me normal music at the beginning of my videos. It'd be dedicated to me husband Lee. We've been married 15 years. My darling, I love you. With all me heart I do. I've always loved you from the time I was two. My darling, you're in my heart. When you're here or there apart, we've been together from the start. My darling Lee, come with me tonight. Let me hold you tight, my sweet darling Lee. Oh, I love you, Lee, my sweet darling. I'm in the mood for love tonight. And my heart is pounding hard. Come with me, my darling Lee. Oh, I love you, Lee. Darlings, and welcome back to my channel. I'm all happy this week. I've been married 15 years tomorrow. 15 years anniversary tomorrow. And 2 Inch has gone out with her father tonight, looking round to find a nice restaurant so we can go out for a nice meal. Oh, 15 years. It's been a long bloody time. But I tell you, it's been worth it. Because I love my husband with all my heart. I can feel myself filling up. I met my husband when I was, I must have been 15 when I first went out with my husband, and we went out for a little while as kids at 15, and you know, I fell in love with him then, but things didn't work out as they do when you're at school and you leave school and you find someone else and you move on and stuff. Well, I didn't move on, I just left school, you know, and done my little thing. Anyway, about 16, 17, I was 17. Now, my husband, his sister came knocking at my door one day because she just had a baby. And she come over to see how I were. And I said, oh, come in, me darling. I haven't seen you in donkeys. Because I used to go to school with his sister, you see. And so I said to her, how's Lee these days? How's he keeping? Is he all right? You know, with these computer games and stuff. Because I think that's half the problem. When I first dated him, he was on that bloody computer. And I just wasn't ready to settle down with a PC at that time in my life, you know. I wanted to go out and do things, but things don't always work out like you want them to. Anyway, she was saying, oh, he's fine. Why don't you come over and have a nice cup of tea around my mum's house? Because she was still living at her mum's at the time. So I said, all right, then I'll come over. Anyway, so I get there and I goes upstairs in her bedroom and she shows me her cot and whatnot, you know, for what she got for the baby. Oh, beautiful baby, little Lukey. Anyway, in comes Lee. Where? It will love all over again. I see him standing there with his long black hair. Because he had the most gorgeous long black hair. And them gorgeous eyes. And he got these eyebrows that go up and they go down, you know. I shall have to show you a nice picture of him one day. Anyway, I said, well, hello there, my darling. How are you keeping? And he says, I'm all right, he said. I said, well, that's all right then, my darling. And then from that point on, as we looked into each other's eyes, I didn't ask him out. That's the funny thing. And he didn't ask me out. Well, we started going out with each other again. From that moment on, it was just like we never split up. And of course, I'd go over there the next day and say hello, and he'd take me out on his motorbike, because he had a motorbike. He had, I think it was a Silver Wing, I think. A big stereo on it. I was a bit of a bikeress in my day, believe it or not, I were. Yeah, bike rallies the lot. Anyway, we started dating again. Well, I got to 19 and things were still going swimmingly with him, you know. And I got myself pregnant, didn't I? Oh, I was so worried. I thought, am I going to tell my mother and all this, that and the other? Well, anyway, I told my mother and she was over the moon, she were. Well, Lee, my husband, well, my boyfriend at the time, I say my husband, my boyfriend at the time, he says, well, I suppose we better do the right thing then, you know. You've got to set a good example for the babies, for the offspring. So, on my 19th, we decided to get married. I was 19 when I got married. Yes, I was, and that's the honest, God's honest truth. Well, we got married when I was about, I think I was about 5.5 months pregnant at the time when I was married. But I was still lovely and slim. Because I was like that when I got married, you know. And we had our little daughter when I got to 20. And ever since then, it had been great, you know. We had little Rachel, and then we had little Martin. And 15 years later, I'm still married to him. He was my childhood sweetheart, my one and only love of my life. Oh. I'll tell you now, it's a true story. No lie here. You ask Bob Wagner, he'll tell you. Oh. 15 years though. Oh, it's the happiest day. I tell you, the day I got married, I stood in that registry office. And the vicar said to me, he said, I call him a vicar, you know what I mean, the man who married us, he said to me, he said, do you take Lee David Dinkin to be your lawful wedded husband? Well, I cracked up and I wet my knickers nearly, I did. I couldn't stop laughing because that's not his name, you see. Dinkin? No. Well, I stood there and I just couldn't stop laughing. And he looked at me, this vicar, he was like, are you all right, love? I was like, that's not his name, that's not how you say his surname. But anyway, it was so nice. And after the church, we went down to the local pub down the road. We all had a nice drink. And then they all wished us off. We went down to Yarmouth for a whole week. It was lovely down in Yarmouth. And when we got down there, bloody stupid me, my brains... There was this ticket conductor on the pier front, and he was selling tickets to win a car. This is the funny bit. Well, I goes and writes my name out. Sarah, blah, blah, blah. Blah. And my husband goes to me, now, come on, love. You've put your old surname. You're not that anymore, are you? Well, I clean forgot I just got blinking married, didn't I? I felt like a right donkey. But I until this day, I still can't get over I did that, you know. But anyway, I thought I'd let you know how we're doing and that. Hopefully tomorrow night I'll be out on the Raz with my husband and having a nice meal and drinking my pina coladas. I love them, they're just so nice. I can drink them like a fish. I love them. Oh, I can't wait. Anyway, my darlings, I thought I'd come and say hello. And if I'm not too drunk when I get in tomorrow night, I'd come on here with 2 inch and I'll try and get the husband to show his little bit of his face for you, because it's lovely. Anyway, my darlings, you take cares tonight. Have a good evening all, okay? And I just want to tell you all, I love you all. And just knowing that you know that I'm happy, and me happy knowing that you're happy, makes me happier. So you all have a good evening, all right? Take care now, my darlings. Toodle-pip now. Toodle-pip.